Hello, and welcome to part two. In this video, we'll add an interactive selection window using Out-GridView to our script that finds the groups of one user and makes another user a member of those same groups. If we compare the finished script here with the one from part one, we can see two changes. The first is that the SAM account names of Michelle and Paul are assigned to variables at the very top. Any user-defined variables should be at the top to make it easier to find for anyone making changes to the script. Our script here is fairly simple, and these SAM account names are easy to find, but you could probably imagine the ordeal in a script that has hundreds or thousands of lines of code, so it's a good habit to get into. The second change is that we've added the Out-GridView to filter or select groups before assigning them to the selected groups variable. So this feature is added to the script because there are scenarios in which an administrator blindly copying group membership would be a huge problem. Let's say that user Michelle Adams is now a supervisor of the sales team at the breakdown lab and has access to a restricted network folder via the sales supervisors group. Our new user Paul should not have access to this specific folder, but should have access to all the other network folders for the sales team. Now, we still want to leverage PowerShell to help automate this task, but also want to have an administrator filter out any groups that may not be appropriate for our new user. This is where Out-GridView is very useful. What Out-GridView does is display a PowerShell object in an interactive table. To show a quick example of how the grid view displays a PowerShell object, we'll use the getAdUser command from the previous video. We'll type in getAdUser-identity-michelle.adams. Now let's compare that to the grid view output by piping the command into Out-GridView. We can see that the output displays the properties distinguished name, enabled, name, and so on. And those are the same in the window columns. To get a full appreciation of what Out-GridView can do, let's try it with all AD users. Let's type in getAdUser-filter*, and then pipe that to Out-GridView. Now that we have many results with multiple properties, we can begin to explore the features of the GridView window. Now, the GridView window has many features. One of them is that you can sort the rows by clicking on the column header. On the first click, you will see a small up arrow indicating that the rows are sorted in ascending order, and that is A to Z alphabetically or small to large numerically. On the second click, the small arrow will change from up to down, indicating that the rows are sorted in descending order, that is, Z to A reverse alphabetically, or large to small numerically. If you want to hide a column, right-click on Column Header and select Select Columns. From the Selected Columns box, select a column name and click on the double left arrow button and hit OK, and it'll be removed from the window. This field at the top is called Quick Filter, and it will search all properties of the PowerShell objects displayed in the window that matches the typed pattern. If we type M-I-C-H, it would find both Michelle and Michael because their given names both begin with M-I-C-H. To search a specific property, click the Add Criteria button and check the box for the property to search. In this case, select Surname. And surname is another name for last name or family name, and then we'll click Add. We'll leave the selection on Contains, but you can have other filtering options. Type in the last name Adams, and now only Michelle Adams is shown in the results. When you want to pass the selection from a grid view window to the console, you'll use the dash PassThru parameter. Now, whenever we select a user and hit OK, the object is then output to the console. You can output multiple users by holding the Control key while clicking, and all selected users are then output to the console. Do note that hiding columns in the grid view window does not affect the object during pass-through. To give the window a title, use the dash title parameter.
O'Doyle rules!
So here is how we've used Out-GridView in the script. For those with a keen eye, you'll have noticed that we've used double quotes instead of single quotes for the GridView window title text. When using a variable in a text string, the double quotes are used to display the value of the variable, and single quotes are used to display the literal text. So here is the text displaying the target user variable with single quotes, and the text displaying target user variable with double quotes.
Enough talk!
So this time, instead of using run selection, I'll type the name of the script file from PowerShell. I'll then control-click the groups to add Paul2, leaving out the sales supervisor group, and hit OK. Verify the results in ADUC, Paul Allen is now a member of all of Michelle's groups, except the sales supervisor group. This concludes part 2. As always, the script as shown and the write-up will be uploaded to my GitHub, which is linked in the description. Thank you for watching, and I hope you learned something.